This video presents the paper Gear Control of Floating Base Systems with Contact Stable Parameterized Force Feedback, accepted for publication to Transaction of Robotics. In the paper, we present a novel control architecture for humanoid robots, which allows our robot ICAB to perform highly dynamic movements. The key contribution of the paper is the use of force feedback coming from force-source sensor while ensuring the continuity of the control input. Balancing controllers for humanoid robots are often formulated as quadratic programming problems. The problem usually consists in minimizing the square error norm of one or more control tasks, subject to a set of constraints on the system dynamics, kinematics, and contact stability. The control task is often the stabilization of the robot momentum. However, these task-based QP control architectures may suffer of two limitations. The QP solution, that is, the system accelerations, joint torques, and contact forces, may be discontinuous, and no direct feedback from force-to-sensor measurements is used in the control design. Additional tasks on the contact forces may be added to the cost function, but they will alter task priorities. To overcome the above-mentioned limitations, in the paper we write the control task in terms of acceleration derivative or jerk. In the language of automatic control, the gear control represents a so-called dynamical extension of the system dynamics, which allow us to consider the system acceleration, torques, and contact forces in the system state and use it as part of the feedback. Differently from classical QP-based controllers, in the jerk formulation the search variable is composed of the contact branch derivative. So the problem is, how can we guarantee with this new formulation that the contact stability constraints are respected? Our solution is to find a parametrization of the contact forces into a new set of variables that always respect the contact stability constraints. With this formulation, it is no more necessary to add contact stability constraints to the QP, because they are always respected thanks to the parametrization. Observe that in the final control design, we choose as control output the momentum acceleration, or center of mass jerk, and a postural task to keep a desired robot posture. We validated our control architecture on the robot ICAB. In this experiment, the robot is balancing while a person applies external and model disturbances. The human force is sensed by the force-source sensors, and the gear controller is able to react and maintain a good tracking of the desired momentum thanks to the use of direct force feedback. In this second experiment, the robot performs highly dynamic movements while balancing. The robot can switch from 2 feet to 1 foot balancing and vice versa, thanks to a state machine that generates proper references according to the number of feet in contact. The controller must accomplish 2 tasks: the stabilization of the desired robot momentum in order to keep balancing, and the achievement of reference trajectories for the robot joints. In conclusion, we compare the performances of the gear control architecture with a classical QP formulation during 10 highly dynamic movements experiments. The gear controller helps in achieving smoother transitions between 1 and 2 feet balancing.